I was wrong in doing what I did.
No, no! No! Are you listening?
There are a number of topics that I could discuss, but I want to touch on a few today. The first one, I don't think I've spoken about. This is how Lauren measures his intelligence, and this is important. This is how someone with the disorders that Lauren has, with the defense mechanisms, this is how they measure their intelligence. This is important. Lauren measures his intelligence by what he thinks he catches other people in, what he believes that other person is doing, how clever it is of him to figure it out, because apparently everything is a riddle to him. But he believes, if I can catch other people being stupid, that makes me smart. If I can see my brother Roy being stupid, that makes me smart, because look, I caught it. That's why he's so proud. What a book, what a joke, what do you know? However he says that bull crap. But he thinks he's so smart. To him, he's a genius.
Spinning, probably laying in bed with you right now, watching a movie or something.
Or like the Hillborn call last night.
You were with Will all day.
Will's been gone for a couple days. No apology, no nothing. I'm sorry. Oh, Lauren, I'm proud of you.
I'm sorry that you're so angry. I'm not sorry for how I feel.
It's so dramatic. I think he really believes that's something that a woman desires. Is, I'm just going to be open with you about my feelings. Even if they're irrational, and even if they're just going to make you angry or hurt you, I don't care. I'd rather be honest with you. I can't even with him sometimes. When I hear him telling Jamie exactly what he's doing, but he does not see it. He realized Jamie was going to get off the phone. And what happened? What was the first thing that happened? I'm sorry. And he had it. Lauren had to stop and think. This is his intelligence level in action. He had to stop and think what exactly an apology sounds like. You could hear him trying to formulate it in the inflection. In that sentence, on those words, the emphasis he put, you could just hear him, like, proud of himself for coming up with a coherent sentence like, I'm sorry for, oh gosh, the way I behaved. And if you asked him what he did, it would be the one thing he knew he did. I was angry. That's why he identifies, so I'm sorry, I'm angry, I'm jealous, I'm angry. Because that's what he identifies, because that's what he feels. He knows how he feels, doesn't know what he's doing. We talked about his feelings being how he remembers things. And I told you to do that experiment where you're watching something on TV, playing a video game, and you either watch that show back in a couple days and it'll spark a memory from that one difficult part of the video game, or you play the video game and you get to that one point and maybe you remember the funny part of the television or the scary part. Doesn't matter. But Lauren's, you know, his memory, emotions. But he can only apologize for how he feels, not for what he's done. Because I don't think he knows what he does, because he does what he does because of how he feels. Probably in his early 20s, he was still trying to be charming. When you're younger and you still have those good looks, your eyes still have that shine in them. Ric Flair somehow kept his until he was in his 50s. They still have that sparkle in them, literal sparkle in them. Everything's just perfect. Then as you get older and you start to lose that, if the only thing you had going for you was that you were kind of cute, you were kind of charming, that's it. You're now not that guy anymore. You've officially moved into what you didn't ever want to move into if you're Lauren Armstrong. And that's someone that has to be taken at face value. You don't tolerate as much stuff because he's creepy and disgusting looking. That is the nature of the beast. I have seen people get away with so much stuff because they're handsome or they're beautiful. They dress nice. They look the part. People tend to overlook things. Lauren is a bullshitter, but he's not smart. We just discussed this. He probably believed he was smart about all of the excuses he used.
Well, got away with that one. Look at that.
It wasn't until, well, even before NBC, he he was paranoid and jealous and angry. Because again, he really wants attention. I think the Shaq has always been a bonus thing for him in his head. If you've met somebody who values something more than something else, they're going to want it. And that other something, they'll take if it comes along. And the only time I ever believed Lauren might have had Shaq was when he was talking about this super loose woman or somebody's mom or mom. Somebody's mom, because that would turn him on. A mom. Maybe it was a woman who was drunk, and there's Lorne, and she's known him for a long time. Because it's almost like the frog in the boiling water. You gradually heat it up, you know, that old story. But Lorne, you know him, you've seen him age, you know what he used to look like, and you tend to see some of that person still there. Maybe he had Shaq. Maybe it was because she felt sorry for him. If he really did, she was like, oh man, this guy's still a virgin and he's like 30. All right, let's go do it. But I doubt it. And as I said before, if he was somebody else's mom, that was probably what he wanted more than anything else. Because I think his mom, I think she started to just dislike her own child. I mean, can you blame her? You don't want to deal with that child anymore. You want that child to go away because you're now going into your golden years, and the last thing you want is a freaking problem child. You don't want to be babysitting for the rest of your life. But with Lauren, that's exactly what you'd be doing, babysitting for the rest of your life. Because his intelligence, his whole life has been, how did I get over on that person? How did I catch them in this? The scenario I imagined in my head, I'm pretty freaking clever. And he craves attention more than anything else in the world. So if you put those two things together, you're going to get the jealousy and the paranoia. Because again, Lauren's entire life is this whirlwind of shame. And I wouldn't say tragedy. Well, for his family, probably a tragedy that they have to associate with this guy. But it's been this soap opera that he wrote, which is why it's not a very clever show, his life. Because he wrote it. His book. Look at how he wrote his book. That's how he wrote his life, unintentionally. Those are the things that he's done that just made him a complete and total failure. So when you're listening to him talk to Jamie, and God knows with Jamie, you can kind of understand why he would be jealous, paranoid. But again, she said, well, I'm talking about the robot when I say this. Jamie Amy, the robot, said one of the most profound things in Lauren's life that he should have listened to and understood. I would have given him some credit. Lauren, I'm a hot porn star. As I'm implying that part. I'm a hot porn star. I'm living with a guy with an Adonis penis who's great at Shaq. I could bang him anytime I wanted. But that's not good enough for Lauren. Again, he's not very smart. So what Lauren does is he's going to push her into making that decision. Because he's tired of the jealousy. He's tired of the anger. He doesn't know how to stop it because he loves it. He's tired of the jealousy. He's tired of the anger. So it's almost like he's off the hook if Jamie does cheat on him. Okay, now I'm justified. But if he stays angry too long and it's not justified, I think that bothers him even more, to be perfectly honest with you. He's trying to get to the point where that anger is justified. But it never is. When you're in the real world, when Lauren was in the real world and he was working at a job, people are going to do things that just irritate you. People that you're nice to, and the nicer you are to them, the more helpful you try to be, the angrier they get, because they're the type of people who will take advantage of that situation. I'm dealing with one right now. Unbelievable, man. Un-fucking believable. He would have those little scenarios that he could just get angry We know he sits around and dreams it all up. So if you're in real life, he's going to come in the next day either angrier or happier because he's worked out why you might have done what you did. With Lorne, it's going to be most of the time something bad. But with a lot of people, they sit back and they're like, you know what? That person is going through a lot right now. They're struggling. Maybe they just had a divorce. They're having problems seeing their kids or something. You know how you are. You sit back and you try to put yourself in their shoes. Lorne will never put himself in their shoes because when he does, they're doing every bad thing that he could possibly think of. It's not going to end. It's too late for him. I don't think you could reel him back in. I mean, the guy looks like he does, acts like he does. He has zero chance with the real woman. He's so used to throwing a tantrum and getting his way. Everything ends up with, just do whatever you want, Jamie. Even though he's the one who's absolutely ruined the relationship. But look, you, Jamie, I want to marry you. So he's so desperate, but he can't stop himself from trying to sabotage it. And that lends itself kind of to my theory that he wants to get to the part where they're angry. Yes, he enjoys being angry. We've discussed that. You've discussed that. He wants that justification. He wants to get to the end where he can be angry. Now he feels good. As I say, it probably annoys some of you. He's in the pocket. That's where he wants to stay, in that little sweet spot. All of my suspicions, all of my anger was justified. The weirdest thing, and I'll mention it again, is when Emma was telling Lorne about Ramona's sexual exploits with the doctor. I gotta get off the phone. I gotta process this. I still think he was fapping to it or trying to. Because we all know we would have said, just stop. I don't want to hear anymore. I just feel sick. You just wouldn't want to hear about it at all. You get to a point in your marriage where you no longer want to hear that stuff. Just, I don't want to know. We've been together for 15 to 20 years. Because if I find out, I know what's going to happen. An ugly divorce. The kids are going to find out. I watched a situation unfold where someone's dad was like a PE teacher. I don't know what it was. A coach, maybe. I just know it was sports related. And there was a young, early 20s, a 22, 23 year old, and they started having an affair, and he thought with his virgin penis, he thought with his penis, and it ruined lives. Lorne thinks everyone else thinks with their penis. He doesn't understand that doing that ruins lives. It is never good to think with it, with your wee willy winky, because Lorne did once for all to see. One time, we saw it, and look what happened to him. NBC. So honestly, his behavior over time is a result of what he used to do to get away with things never works anymore. I mean, look at the guy, and he's on video call. I think I'm gonna have a cigarette. And you're looking at his jawline shrink from being toothless on the bottom. You're looking at his bottom jaw, just kind of, the bones are weakening, and you're seeing this guy. He's so weird. I mean, the dude never got the meatballs. Anyway, those are my thoughts. I love you guys. I'll see you in the next one. What?